No fail, every single video that I upload with my wife Coco being the model, I will always get questions or comments like how I wish my wife would agree to do that, how I wish my girlfriend or my daughter or my son would agree to do that. Well, in today's video, I will share with you the secret on how to make your loved ones your photography model. So before anything else, if you guys haven't subscribed to the channel and would want to learn more about off-camera flash photography, then this channel is for you. So you might want to consider subscribing and click that notification bell so that you get notified every time I upload a new video. And also to help out the channel, click that like button too. Now, if you want to see more of my images, you could always follow me on Instagram. It's at Jiggie Alejandrino. So hi everyone, this is Jiggie, a portrait and wedding photographer from the Philippines, and welcome to the channel. So as I said in my intro, in today's video, I will share with you some of the reasons on, or the techniques, not necessarily techniques, but I will share with you how I was able to convince my wife Coco to be my photography model. So if you guys are not new to the channel, you know that 90% of all my lighting instructional videos, I use Coco or I share the stage with my wife Coco, who is always going to be my subject. Why? Well, I have six reasons. Well, the first one is I actually told Coco that I would rather be shooting her than strangers, because personally, in photography, well, when I started photography, I really started to be able to document my life with my family and my kids. And since the start of the pandemic, well, prior to the start of the pandemic, I have been shooting Coco, but not this much. But since I started this YouTube channel, I decided that maybe it's best that I actually use or ask Coco to be my model, because every single image that I take from then or from there, it means something to me, or it's more special to me. It's like documenting her life. And at the same time, it's also nice to be able to make her look beautiful, right? Another way for you to be able to really convince your loved one to be your photography model is that you have to make them feel confident with you as a photographer. You have to prove to them that you are a good photographer. Well, you have to prove that. In other words, there will come a point in which you have to break the ice. In other words, you just need to be able to get that one amazing photograph of her, and that should really open the floodgates. So how do I suggest you do that? Well, number one, it's best that you actually go for the simplest light setup that you can think of that will give you fantastic results. If you want a bit of inspiration, you could go through some of my instructional videos here in the channel. But if you are still new to off-camera flash photography, I would suggest looking for the most beautiful light that you can find in your home, maybe that window light. And all you have to do is take one really tight shot and at the same time use your best portrait lens. I would suggest maybe an 85mm up to a 135 and shoot wide open. I don't normally tell everyone to shoot wide open, but in this case there is something beautiful about blurring out the background. So just make sure that you have her in beautiful light, shoot her with the best lens possible, blur out the background, no fail, she will look beautiful. And by doing that, you can now move forward into something even more complicated, or at least, at the very least, get her confident that you have some photography skills. Then third is hire a makeup artist. So you've done your initial groundwork in terms of making her feel comfortable in front of the camera, or not necessarily comfortable, but you've broken the ice by taking that one beautiful shot. If you want to take it to the next level, hire a professional makeup artist, because honestly, ladies, all of them, they want to feel beautiful, and having a good makeup artist play around with their face will really give them the confidence to be able to be in front of the camera and with you shooting them. So take that time, take that investment, and just make them feel beautiful. And next after that is make sure that you make her feel comfortable in front of the camera. By always complimenting her, always making sure that when you take that shot, they feel comfortable in front of the camera. You tell them, oh, babe, you look fantastic. Or you can call them by their name if you're not used to calling them babe or sweetheart or whatever it is. Just make sure that even if you're taking a photograph that's not necessarily that nice, you don't tell them that. Because you are always just going to be looking for that one shot. And then you show them the picture that you think she is most beautiful in. And the moment you show it, you say, babe, look at this. You look fantastic here. Look at your eyes. Look at the shape of your face. Look at the smile. It's just beautiful. Okay? That's very, very important whenever you're shooting someone who is a non-model. So you have to be able to make them feel comfortable in front of the camera. Next, this is actually very superficial, but it really did work for me. It gave us an opportunity for us to actually, maybe for me to... not sustain, but rather to support the thing that girls love most. And I don't want this to be a cliche, but of course, everybody wants to shop for clothes. Everybody wants to shop for makeup. And for me, when I started shooting Coco, it gave her that reason to actually buy more clothes and to do more makeup or to learn makeup actually in general, because obviously she did know how to put makeup on her own. But ever since the start of the pandemic, Mela Jimenez, our good friend, has been helping her out. And by helping her out, she's actually learning how to put on her makeup even better. And at the same time, I actually fully support her when she says, oh, babe, I need to buy this, I need to buy that, I need to buy that. I go, by all means, get everything that you need. And, you know, the nice thing about that, it's not like you're spending it for nothing. You're spending it for content. You're spending it for pictures. It is actually money well spent. At the same time, you could actually turn it the other way around and say, hey, babe, you know what? I think I need new lens to be able to shoot you better. So they might actually even support your hobby at the same time you are supporting them. Because, of course, when I remember when Coco will say, hey, babe, can I buy this? I go, babe, will we be able to use it for a shoot? Then she goes, yeah, of course, and go by all means. See, I'm 100% supportive, but I do actually support her every time she wants to get something. But now she has more reason to actually get something and say that you can't actually say no because I'm going to use it for one of her shoots. Okay, so it's a push and pull thing, or it's like I scratch your back, you scratch mine. And lastly, every time we are shooting, we're actually bonding. It's a time for us to be away from the kids. It's time for us to actually talk. You know, while she's doing her makeup or while I'm setting up, we do a lot. We do talk a lot. And it's good quality time for us. And at the same time, you know, one other thing that's actually not part of this, but it's also part of being comfortable in front of the camera already. But basically, when I started shooting Coco even before I started this YouTube channel. But it's something that we actually enjoyed whenever we're traveling. So right now that we can't travel, it's another way for us to actually have quality time. Because when we're traveling, we love taking pictures of ourselves. We love taking pictures of us together. And, you know, that's how I got comfortable also in front of the camera, because I had to be with her. So if she was comfortable in front of the camera, I had to be comfortable in front of the camera too. But definitely she looks a lot better in front of the camera. But it's good quality time for us. It's a time for us to be able to bond, as I said earlier. And when we do get to travel again, then definitely all these things that we've been doing will actually reflect on the travel photos that we will be taking. So that's how simple it was. All I did really was to tell her that the pictures will mean more if she were the subject. I'd rather shoot her than any stranger or any model out there. So now, before we got into all these things, there was a time that we were really very hesitant with each other in front of the camera. I remember when I was starting out in photography, every single image that I took that was bad, it was always her fault. It was never my fault, but in reality, I really didn't have the skills yet at that time. But all it really took was just that one photo. When we were able to get that one photo, it really broke the ice and opened up the floodgates for us to be comfortable with each other. And we just started playing and shooting. And, you know, for the longest time, since 2008, she's always been my muse. Now, from there, when we hired a makeup artist, of course, it became easier because she felt pretty. That's the most important thing, because the moment that they feel pretty, it shows in the camera. It's very easy for you to shoot if she is properly done. Do not say just because they know how to put on makeup, they can do without a professional makeup artist. Make them try being done or made up by a professional makeup artist. It will change her perception of how beautiful she can really be. Okay? Next is make them feel comfortable in front of the camera. Whenever you are shooting them, or especially loved ones, because it's too close for comfort, you have to make sure that you make them feel comfortable. You make them feel comfortable by always complimenting them. It's nice because since you have a personal relationship, you can actually cross that line we never do with models. We can cross that line and be more emotional, be more sympathetic. We can touch our models, basically, because they are our loved ones. When with strangers, you can't do that. So it's nicer, it's actually better if you're shooting a loved one because of the emotional connection that's there, so long as you have the trust. And another thing, was it gave us an opportunity to actually have a reason for all our vices when it comes to shopping. It gave her a reason to buy clothes. It gave her a reason to buy makeup. At the same time, it also gave me a reason to buy more equipment. That was when we were just starting out in photography. But now, you know, everything she buys will have a reason. Like, babe, I can use this for a shoot. And it's fantastic. So she actually even took that effort already now because she thinks that, hey, if we're going to be doing this more often, so I have to dress up a little bit more. Okay. All right. And lastly, the most important thing is that it was quality time for the both of us. It's never work. It's just us really having fun together and just laughing and enjoying and creating content for you guys. Okay. So I hope I was able to shed some light in terms of how I was able to convince my loved one to be my photography model. And I hope it helps you guys too. Okay, so if you did enjoy this video, please do consider subscribing to the channel. And while you're at it, click that notification bell so that you get notified every time I upload a new video. And if you like this video, hit that like button because I just recently discovered it actually helps algorithm and it shows this video to more people. And if you want to see some of my images and the images that I've taken of my wife, Coco, you could always find me on Instagram. It's at Jiggie Alejandrino and her Instagram is Coco Alejandrino. Okay? Till the next video.